Hello, it's Elder here, and today I wanted to go ahead and review this Nightcore battery charger. What ended up happening was I had reviewed a few of these Eastshine 18650 batteries and started receiving a few comments on what I would recommend as a charger. I had been using this i4 made by the same company as Nightcore, and the Eastshine company, also the owners of Nightcore, went ahead and sent me this new SC2 so that I could go ahead and introduce it to you. So let's go ahead and take a closer look. So in the packaging itself, we have our two bay charger here. Very good quality construction. Feels good in a hand, doesn't just feel like a cheap piece of plastic. So you know that there's something in here. We have an AC charger adapter that'll hook up. And we also have a DC adapter that can, I guess, go in your car. Anything that's 12 volt, and also in solar power hookups, you know, things of that nature. And it also comes with a cool little case to be able to store your batteries in. So they throw that in, and then of course a little manual, little thank you card that talks about their 30-day warranty and their how to get in touch with them if you do need support. So it's pretty cool. I like seeing that in companies because it's not like they're trying to hide from you. All right, they're saying, hey, we're here if you need us or you find something wrong, go ahead and contact us. So as far as support, never had issues with this company, and don't really foresee any, because if you just check out their information, you'll see that they do respond quickly, and people are generally happy with their support. Now, I'm a complete layperson when it comes to all the technology here and all the voltage and so on and so forth, but luckily this charger does have, let's say, manual settings, and it also has the automatic settings. And luckily for me, it has the automatic settings because like I said, I'm definitely not an electronics guru, so it's pretty good that they cater to people like me. Now, what do I use these batteries for? Basically, these are the charger. I have this 18650 batteries that I use for flashlights, headlamps, vaporizers, also certain optics for my firearms. Also take these type of batteries. So obviously a charger is relatively important. And as I stated earlier, I've been using this earlier model with the four bays, never had a problem. And this one has a lot more bells and whistles that I'm gonna share the info with you now. Now the safety issue, obviously there's a great performance issue here. It charges the batteries really fast. And it has all these other little bells and whistles that aid in our safety. Now if you search YouTube, things of that nature, and you look for exploding batteries, especially in you know, vaporizers, high drain devices, you know, such as these tactical flashlights, you'll notice that people are incurring injuries. These batteries are blowing up in their pocket, and it's causing all sorts of havoc and injuries, and you know, it's not a good thing. So what we really want to keep in mind is we want to keep in mind the quality of our batteries, know where you're getting them from, know what they're all about, and then of course your charging source. And a lot of things that I've seen in the past is you'll end up picking up, let's say, good batteries that have a name, spending the extra couple bucks on them because of safety and credibility, but then we end up using, or people end up using, an inexpensive, cheap charger, and that ends up wreaking havoc on your battery life, and of course, contributing to a lot of these injuries. So we want to make sure that we have a charger that's good to go, that has all sorts of implementations. So this charger stops it from overcharging, stops it from overdraining, notifies you if you put it in backwards, notifies you if the battery is not good or if it's not going to work. And I'll get into that in a minute, just showing you the actual visuals on it. So these little safety features is really what makes me give this charger an approval. It's also a two bay, so it's a lot easier if you do need to throw it in your go bag and have the right setup to be able to charge it, or, you know, of course, can get to a source somewhere down the line. Just because it's an emergency situation doesn't always mean that we don't have access to electricity. So we want to keep that in mind, that this is a lot smaller than, let's say, going with a wider, bulkier one. So just something else to keep in mind, you know, especially for us that are always on the go and looking for these type of solutions. So I went ahead and hooked up the AC adapter here just to give you a little bit of a demonstration. So the positive pole is up here. So if I were to, let's say, reverse it and put the positive going down, if you look at the LED readout here, it just starts blinking like crazy, which basically tells you, hey man, it's a no-go. Something's wrong here. Either it's a defective battery, or, you know, the polarity is wrong, which in this case we know it is. If I go ahead and switch it and put the positive up on top, it'll go ahead, read everything, tell me what it's charging at. One issue or downfall of this charger is this readout here is actually on this tiny little film of paper. So once you pull that off, hopefully you memorized what these settings are, because if not, you're going to be in trouble. And as you could tell, I just tried to pull this off and it'll probably last about another 2 weeks or so. So if you use various chargers like I do, and you're not going to actually remember or recall all of this stuff, just something that you want to make a mental note about, I am definitely notifying the company about this, and hopefully they fix this flaw, because it is relatively simple to fix. And why they went with this solution, I'm not really sure. Charger can handle between both bays here a complete total of 5 amps. So basically, if you're putting this one in here, it's going to charge much quicker because it's going to be at 3 amp. But once you add the second battery, there's only 2 amps left over, so it's going to charge a little bit slower. Another thing to think about here also is this USB, where you could actually charge other devices also. But if you do have a battery in here, it's going to charge the battery in here before it'll go ahead and allow the pass through to the USB to be able to charge your device. So if you want to use the USB port for charging your external device, like your phone or iPod or iPad, whatever you got, make sure that there isn't a battery in here so that the current is completely devoted to the actual USB port. As I stated earlier, you can charge, or the manufacturer states that you can charge all sorts of different batteries, pretty much anything that's rechargeable, but I prefer these more so for, you know, the higher capacity, like these 18650s. I have other chargers for AA batteries, AAA batteries, things of that nature. So just keep that in mind, just something else that the manufacturer boasts about. So if you do have a need, hopefully that'll fill your void, but I definitely can't comment on that because I've only charged these types of batteries with it. So once again, not much more to talk about. There's all sorts of specs on here and the little manual that comes in a book also to tell you about the batteries and the input. And once again, of course, in the blog post, I'll put all the details, because being a layperson, I wasn't going to go ahead and just rattle off stuff that didn't make sense to me. But hopefully if it does make sense to you and you want that type of information, I will put it in detail in our blog post, so make sure that you check it out. So the last thing that I really want to leave you with is the safety, which we already spoke about. Make sure that you're safe out there. These batteries are no joke. They are powerful. Make sure that you stick with brand name batteries that work well for you. And of course, you know, invest in a good charger, because if you're going to spend money on these batteries that cost a little bit more, you want to get as much life out of them as possible. You want to be able to trust them as much as possible, and you definitely don't want them exploding on you. So make sure that you go ahead and do the right thing. Once again, this is Helder. I hope that you enjoyed this review.